Nobody likes brush strokes in their paint, right? So today I'm gonna show you how I eliminate the brush strokes from my painted furniture. Let me get my supplies together and let's get started. Okay, you're gonna need some supplies. First thing you're gonna need is a really good paintbrush. I like this angle brush, it's really cool. And you're gonna need a mister bottle. This is for water, which you're gonna be applying on your furniture, on your brush, and on your paint. And then you're gonna need a really, really good chalk mineral paint. And I'm gonna drop the links below to the supplies that I use for today's demonstration so that you can find the products that I love. Okay, so here we go. First thing I'm gonna do is take my mister bottle and I'm gonna mist over the area where I'm gonna paint. And then I'm gonna mist my brush. The trick is, with no brush strokes, is to keep your paint flowing and moving as you paint. So dip your brush into your paint and then start painting. And as you paint, you're gonna feel your paintbrush. And if it ever gets to where it's dragging or it gets difficult to actually move, you're gonna mist over that lightly and you're gonna keep moving that paint. This also allows you to use less paint. Yay, we all wanna save money, right? So go ahead and put one coat, a very, very light coat, over your piece. Let it dry. And I can't emphasize enough to use a very, very light coat. You're gonna put multiple coats on. This is the way you eliminate brush strokes. What happens when you put a lot of paint on and it's not wet enough, you're gonna create brush strokes. It's almost like an icing on a cake. If you've got thick icing and you're putting it on, you're gonna see that. If you've got something that's really liquid and it's fluid and it flows, you're not gonna see the brush strokes. Again, I'm gonna mist over the furniture. My brush is already wet. And I'm gonna take a little bit of paint on my brush and we're gonna paint back and forth. And always be mindful of your paintbrush and how it feels. Dragging it over your furniture, it should be smooth. It should not drag and catch. It shouldn't be rough. You can also listen to the sound that your paintbrush makes. I know that sounds kind of strange, but it's true. It makes a different sound when it's wet versus when it's dry. Try it and see. And it's okay, you're going to see through the paint on the first coat. Most paints take more than one coat, and especially when it's a chalky based paint, it's okay. Your first coat is not gonna cover up everything. So don't worry about getting a thick coat on, just a nice light coat. Let it dry, rinse and repeat. Two coats of paint, two coats of chalk mineral paint. The difference is that when you use water, you use your mister and you blend and you actually thin your paint down, you're gonna get a much smoother finish than you would if it was a thick consistency. Remember, consistency is key with a smooth finish, because if you have something that's thick, it's tending to be raised to the surface. If it's more fluid like water, what happens when you pour water over something? It just kind of, it levels out, right? So use more water with your water-based chalky paints. Use a good brush, one light coat, let it dry. Do a second coat, let it dry. If it needs a third, go ahead and paint that third coat. Here's the kicker. It also dries faster because you have a really, really thin coat on, which means the painting process can actually speed up and you use less paint. That is a win-win. Faster, less paint. Hey, that's more money in my pocket. So if you want to take it a step further, I like to use a really super fine sanding pad after I paint, and I just gently buff over the surface. I'm not sanding back and forth. I'm not trying to remove anything, but because it is a chalk mineral paint, sometimes you will get a few little granules, a little chalky look and stuff in there. So, you know, you just kind of lightly rub over it. Super smooth. It feels like someone sprayed it. So that is my tip for you on how to get rid of the brush strokes on your paint. So I hope this helps. I'd love to hear about your painting experiences. Email me at dodsondesign.com. Happy painting!